It's another great day to be responsible for equality and liberty. Thank you all for being here today. My name is Jeffrey M. I am with a group called Responsible for Equality and Liberty. We chose our name, Responsible for Equality and Liberty, to define who we are for and what we are for, rather than what we are against. So many people have organizations that are challenging this and challenging that, and we are challenging things too. But most, first and foremost, we want to never forget what we are for. There's a tenor of negativity that we see throughout a lot of public discourse today that we want to try to also reverse and offer a more positive, more hopeful note to our future. We believe that it was a hopeful note that inspired the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, and we hope that we can change that. Today, December 10 matters. Why December 10 matters? December 10, 1948 was an important date in the history of humanity. On that day, the nations of the world came together amidst the global crimes against humanity during World War II, and were determined to create an international declaration of our most basic rights as human beings to be respected by the nations of the world universally. Their efforts became known as the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. In many ways, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights was the world's way of saying never again. Those who would stand defiant against the forces of apathy, hate, and hopelessness to defend humanity's most basic rights as human beings took courage in the International Declaration. As the years went by, other declarations of human courage continued around the world. Never again was followed by Ich bin ein Berliner, then I have a dream, then there is no such thing as park freedom. From person to person, from city to city, from nation to nation, there has been a continuing march for human freedom. In every step, the advocates for human equality and liberty share a common message. To those who deny such human rights, they say, "We shall overcome." The true context of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights is not just about the times in which it was created, but by the human beings that have dared to stand for it. They are the human beings who recognize the truths that we hold self-evident, that all men and women are created equal and all deserve the inalienable human rights of equality and liberty. They're the human beings that understand that we are one race. They understand that there is truly one omniculture of shared humanity. They understand that there is just one home that we share, where our universal human rights extend to every part of that home of our planet Earth. December 10 was designated as Human Rights Day by the United Nations in remembrance of the December 10, 1948 adoption of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. But not only do we recognize our declaration in support of such universal human rights, but also we recognize those who have denied them, including the totalitarian and supremacist nations and ideologies of the world that seek to continue to deny such universal human rights today. But in challenging those who would deny our universal human rights, we do not offer an upraised fist, but instead, we offer an outstretched hand. Our human rights are their human rights. We urge those who would use their hatred of others to justify denying their human rights to drop the burden of hate from their hearts and to join their brothers and sisters in humanity. We believe that love wins. Our goal to be responsible for equality and liberty. Too many hearts are hardened and numb to the endless stream of human tragedy that is broadcast around the world on a daily basis. Too many ears have been shut to the cries of anguish of our suffering fellow human beings have been focused instead on our differences and quarrels, rather than on what brings us together as a single and as a singular human race. Too many minds have been closed to the infinite possibilities of peace, dignity, and human coexistence grounded on a consistent approach to defending our universal human rights. We come here today to rise above such numbness, such indifference and divisions, and such inflexibility on this December 10th, Human Rights Day, to join the chorus of past declarations of courage and declare our support for our universal human rights for all of humanity.